All right, guys. So the first step you want to do is take the centering pin out. It doesn't matter if it's on the vehicle or off the vehicle. You can try to unbolt it with some heat. You can try doing whatever you want. We just ended up cutting ours off because we needed a longer one anyway. So we're trying to drive it through with a punch. And what actually ended up happening was we got it to go, but then it stopped and it ended up mushrooming. So we had to actually do a lot more work than we were hoping to do. Basically, what we did is this is on an 88 one ton, and right here you can see us taking off just like the leaf spring holders, I guess they are. I don't really know what they're considered, but they just kind of hold the end of the leaf spring together. So we have to heat that up and we get that all off. But basically, what we're doing is an 88 one ton Chevy dump truck. And where this leaf pack is actually already a leaf pack bigger than the one that's on it, and because it's off of like a newer truck, and then we're taking the overload from the old leaf pack and putting it onto this. So basically, they came with or without an overload, and the truck had it with an overload, and the one we got it off of without an overload, which had an extra leaf spring. So that's how, we're making it a stiffer leaf spring basically, because it's on a dump truck, so it's going to get abused, obviously. So we want to make sure that the owner can do whatever they want. So here you can see we got the top leaf off, and we ended up having to fight with it again because it's mush. Like I said, it's mushroomed, so we cut it off, or we ground it off again, and then we kind of just keep going like this. This leaf spring is actually like plastic riveted together, so you can't take the entire thing apart, but we got it far enough apart where we could release the rust and we could just get that pin out. Because that's all we really need to do is get this pin out. We didn't have to do anything else. But you can see he's got the pliers on the bottom and he's kind of hitting it. Then I grab the punch because he's doing, side to side. So I'm just gently tapping because we don't want to mushroom it again because of where it's at. We'd have to do a lot more work than we already had to do. So he pulls that out the bottom. I just kind of stick that in there and leave it there so it holds it all together. Then I just start reassembling. Now these are the ones that we just took off of here. So I'm just putting those back on and, reassembling them, making sure they're straight, so when we put the bolt back in, everything is okay. There you see the original top leaf going back on because it has the eyelids at the end. So also be sure to check out my other video if you need to know how to replace leaf spring bushings. We did a video, same truck. Now here you can see a spacer. It's like an inch spacer and then an overload. You can kind of see at the upper left of the screen where it sits on the perches when it hits. But we're just sticking a bolt back in it that we found because we did not have one long enough to be able to get the whole thing. We ended up just putting that in later, which I'm sure you guys can figure out how to do that. Just put a bolt in it. It does not have to be a centering pin. You can just use a bolt. If the bolt head's too big, just round it off. But I hope this video helps you guys. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more content. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks, guys.